My name is Eric Coslin, Technical Marketing Engineer for Cisco Systems. I will discuss and demonstrate AWS target failover with the Cisco Secure Firewall. This is a way we can have connection level resilience in the public cloud. A brief background on clustering. Clustering is a way to combine multiple firewalls into a single logical device. This allows pay as you grow. You can add nodes as your throughput requirements increase. It supports up to 16 nodes depending upon the platform. Clustering was originally invented for physical firewalls, and in particular for the Cisco ASA firewall. It was later adapted to physical Cisco Secure Firewall Threat Defenses, or FTD. More recently, it was extended to virtual firewalls. In particular, in the 7.2 release, it was extended to AWS. Now, because the connection state is shared between nodes, it may provide the connection level resilience that we're looking for. But this depends upon the behavior of the load balancing to the nodes. For example, with physical devices, most customers use EtherChannel, and EtherChannel along with LACP guarantee the resilience of the connections by rebalancing to the healthy node. With virtual devices, it very much depends on exactly which load balancer we're talking about and the behavior of that load balancer in terms of rehashing the existing flows. In AWS, the feature for rebalancing the flows is often referred to as target failover. This moves existing connections from unhealthy nodes to healthy nodes. However, it's only available on the gateway load balancers, and it is disabled by default. To configure it, it's fairly simple. It's an attribute of the target group. In the AWS console, you'll see this in the screenshot on the right. If you're using the API or the AWS CLI, you should recognize that the single attribute in the console is actually the conjunction of two attributes, which are more granular and depend upon the reason that the target is unavailable, either through deregistration or through being identified as unhealthy. And of course, these attributes are available in cloud formation templates. So for the demonstration, I have an application VPC with two servers. I'm going to establish a connection between the two servers, but I want the connection to be inspected by the firewalls. So I insert a gateway load balancer endpoint in the data path. The gateway load balancer endpoint is an object that intercepts traffic and sends it through a private link to the gateway load balancer. The gateway load balancer then balances the connections through a Genevieve tunnel to the FTD cluster. I will, through packet capture, determine which node this particular connection is being hashed to, and then I will shut down that node. What we will see is the connection rehashed to the other node, and the connection will be maintained between the servers. A comment on the health probe settings. I set them as aggressively as possible for purposes of the demo, but even this compares poorly to what you would see with a physical cluster, in which case the EtherChannel would give you the sub-second failover. So here we see that we have two healthy targets. There are our health check settings. And you can see both targets are healthy at this point. These two targets are members of a cluster. The one on the left is the control node. The one on the right is a data node, but that really doesn't matter. Let's start a TCP connection to port 12345 using netcat. And if we look at the packet capture, we can conclude that it is the second node of the cluster that is processing the packets for this connection. I want to show you something about what I did with the policy. It's not best practice. I simply am allowing all of the hairpin traffic for the purposes of the demo. We probably want to be doing something more interesting there. But here's the key. I'm logging twice at the beginning and end of each connection. In production, you typically only log at the end of the connection. But since we've started the connection and we're logging at the beginning of the connection, we should actually already see a log entry. And there we see the connection to port 12345 going through the second node as expected. Now, let me shut down that second node. You'll see that the cluster very quickly determines that that node is unhealthy and removes it from the cluster. Also, fairly quickly, AWS will determine that one of the nodes is unhealthy and will start to rebalance the connection. Notice we did lose one line, that testing line. But other than that, we see now that the connection is still persisting and is going through the first node for inspection. Just to confirm that everything is as we expect, let's look again at the events. We should now see the end of connection event along with the beginning of connection event, and we can determine that the two devices for the beginning and end of the connection are in fact different. And with that, I conclude my demonstration, and thank you for your time.